In this lecture, we are going to discuss some problems using laws of logic. First example, use De Morgan's law to find the negation of the following statements. First one is, Paris is in France and London is in England. Second statement is, John will take a job in industry or go to college. So here, the question is, we need to find the negation of these two statements, okay, by using De Morgan's law. Okay, so we know the De Morgan's law are given by negation of P and Q is logically equivalent to negation P or negation Q. This is the first De Morgan's law. The second De Morgan's law is negation of P or Q is logically equivalent to negation P and negation Q. So these are the De Morgan's law. So we need to use this De Morgan's law to negate these given statements. Okay, so the first statement is this: Paris is in France and London is in England. Okay, so we can just take or consider the propositions. Let P and Q be the propositions given by. P is, Paris is in France. Okay, Paris is in France. This is the proposition P, and the proposition Q is nothing but London is in England. England. London is in England. Okay, so these are the propositions. So our given proposition is actually our statement is Paris is in France and London is in England. That is P and Q. Okay, so therefore the given statement is, given statement is given by what? P and Q. Clear. Paris is in France and London is in England. Therefore, by we need to find the negation of this statement P and Q. Okay, but by De Morgan's law, we have negation P and Q is nothing but negation P or negation Q. Therefore, by De Morgan's law, we have negation of P and Q is logically equivalent to negation P or negation Q. Okay, that is. This is the negation of our required our given statement. Okay, so therefore the negation of given statement is negation P or negation Q. Negation P or negation Q. That is, negation P is nothing but what is P? P is actually Paris is in France. That is Paris not in France. That is negation P. That is Paris not in France. Or negation Q is London is not in England. London is not in England. Clear. So this will be the negation of the given statement. The given statement was Paris is in France and London is in England. Paris is in France and London is in England. The negation is Paris is not in France or London is not in England. Okay. That is, the negation is, this is not true. That means either Paris is not in France or London is in not in England, or both. Okay. So this is the negation of the given statement by De Morgan's law. Now for the second question is, John will take a job in industry or go to college. John will take a job in industry or John will go to college. So we can choose the prepositions PB. John will take a job in industry, and Q be the proposition John will go to college. So we are consider these two propositions. So we need to negate this statement. John will take a job in industry or go to college. So this statement will be what? P or Q. Okay, therefore this given statement is, therefore the given statement is P or Q. So by De Morgan's law, we have negation P or Q is not is logically equivalent to negation P and negation Q. Okay, so that is therefore the negation of the given statement is negation P and negation Q. That is, negation P is nothing but P is John will take a job in industry. So negation P is John will not take a job in industry, and negation Q is John will not go to the college. Okay, so we have negation P and negation Q. That is, negation of the given statement is John will not take a job in industry, and John will not go to college. That is, John will not take a job in industry and John will not go to college. That is, John will neither take a job in industry nor go to college. That is, John will neither take a job in industry nor go to college. Okay, so that is the negation of the given statement by using De Morgan's law. Next question is, determine whether or not the statement x plus 1 is assigned to x will be executed in the following sequence of statements. That is, 7 is assigned to A, 4 is assigned to B. If negation of A less than B or B greater than or equal to 5, then x plus 1 is assigned to x. So our question is to check whether this statement, that was this assignment statement, that is x plus 1 is assigned to x, will be executed or not in this sequence of statements. Okay, so we know this assignment statement executed will be executed only if this statement is true. Okay, so we need to check this statement is true or not. Okay, so here we know a negation of A less than B or B greater than or equal to 5 is logically equivalent to negation of A less than B and negation of B greater than or equal to 5 by De Morgan's law. This is logically equivalent to A greater than or equal to B. That is, negation of A less than B is A greater than or equal to B, and negation of B greater than or equal to 5 is B less than 5. Okay, now we are given that A is assigned by 7 and B is assigned by 4. So since A equal to 7 and B equal to 4, what about this? These statements are true. That is, A greater than or equal to B. That is, 7 is greater than or equal to 4. It is true, and B less than 5 is also true. 4 is less than 5. We have A greater than or equal to B and B less than 5 are true. Okay, therefore this expression is true. Okay, therefore A greater than or equal to B and B less than 5, the expression this is true. Okay, that is the expression negation of A less than B or B greater than or equal to 5 is true. So since this, that means this expression is true. So since this expression is true, this will be executed. This assignment will be, or assignment statement will be executed. Therefore, x x plus 1 assigned to x will be executed. Okay. Next question. Using the laws of logic, simplify the compound proposition P and negation Q, or Q or negation P and Q. So here we need to simplify this expression by using the laws of logic. Okay. So first, by using associative law, this expression is logically equivalent to this P and negation Q or Q or this. Okay. So we can use the associative law to change this expression like this. Okay. Now then, using commutative law, we can interchange these two expressions. That is, P or P and negation Q or Q is nothing but Q or P and negation Q. So this is logically equivalent to this now. Okay. Now using the distributive law, we can write this as this is Q or P and negation Q. So by using distributive law, that is distributive of this or over and, that is Q or P and Q or negation Q. Q or P and Q or negation P, negation Q. This is by distributive law. Then we know Q or negation Q is nothing but T. That is by inverse law. Okay, Q or negation Q is logically equivalent to T by inverse law. Okay, so we can write this expression is logically equivalent to Q or P and T or negation P and Q, right? Now by identity law, we have P and T is logically equivalent to P itself. So treating this as a P, that is Q or P, and T is nothing but that is logically equivalent to Q or P itself. Okay. So this is logically equivalent to Q or P by identity law. So we can write this as logically equivalent to this. Then by using the distributive law, we can write that is this, we are distributing these two here. That is Q or P or negation P and Q or P or negation or Q. Right. That is Q or P or negation Q. Sorry, negation P. And Q or P or Q, right? That is by distributive law. We are distributing this over this, right? So we can express this as just equivalent to this. Okay. So that is by distributive law. Now by associative law, we can just change this expression as this. That is Q or P or negation P can be written as Q or P or negation P. Okay, so this is by associative law. Now we have P or negation P is nothing but T by inverse law. P or negation P is nothing but T. Okay, that is by inverse law, we can write this as T. Okay, now we have Q or T and Q or P or Q. Now by domination law, we know that Q or T is nothing but, or it is equivalent to this T. Q or T is, by domination law, we have Q or T is equivalent to T itself. So you know, this is this can be expressed as, well, this is logically equivalent to T and Q or P or Q, right? Now by using commutative law, we can interchange this and this. So Q or P or Q and T will be here. So this is equivalent to this. Okay. Then by using identity law, we know something that is P and T is equivalent to P. Okay, logically equivalent to P. That is by identity law. Okay, so this and T is logically equivalent to this itself. So Q or P and Q, P or Q itself. Okay, so from this we can use commutative law. That is Q or P or Q is nothing but, or it is logically equivalent to P or Q or Q. This P or Q or Q by commutative law. Okay. Now by using associative law, we can write this as P or Q or Q. P or Q, or Q is by associative law. We know Q or Q is nothing but Q itself. So it is by idempotent law. So P or Q or Q can be it is logically equivalent to this. So P or Q itself. Okay. So we simplify the our expression to P or Q. Clear. So for this we need to know our laws of logic, all the laws of logic clearly. So then we can just apply these laws to our compound propositions to make them simplify. Okay, to simplify that you can. And first thing is we need to know all laws clearly. Okay, now you can try to prove this using the laws of logic. Simplify the compound proposition this to Q and R. Okay, so you just try to simplify this proposition negation of P or Q and R, or negation Q. You just apply the laws of logic and simplify this to this Q and R. Okay, I'm leaving this as a homework. Also, you try to do these problems.